in the 60s, there was the so-called sexual revolution, but gays were not part of it. It's still, you know, the word gay didn't even really exist in the 60s as a term for homosexuality. It was still, oh, isn't it gay, meaning isn't it festive?
The police would suddenly raid a disco and catch people who were dancing with members of the same sex. So what you had to have was one woman, at least, in every group. And you might have seven boys dancing together and one girl. But there had to be the girl. Employees of the disco would sit on top of very tall ladders with a flashlight. And if they saw you with a girlless group, they would turn the light on and you'd have to immediately get yourself a girl if you were going to continue.
This is the Stonewall where gay liberation began, where street queens had had enough, rioted, and decided to become part of the world. People moving up, running, but you sure can't hide. They just said, all right, get going, with that horrible look, and they turned around, but no one left. And he just couldn't believe it, so he turned around again and said, I told you to get going. And then, for some reason, we all started marching towards them.
That was the birth of the gay rights movement. That happened on Friday night, June 27th, 1969.
At the time of I Feel Love, that kind of music was very underground. You know, it was Kraftwerk were very underground still. He was doing a concept album about the history of music or the history of dance music, and I Feel Love was going to be the last track of the album because that was about the future of dance music. I don't know if that's right or not, but that's my understanding. And so, and I only found that out later. But, I mean, he was prescient and predicted the future in a very good way.
I love gay clubs. I went to gay clubs. And for people who were straight in a gay club, it was a wonderful environment to be in. People were what you would call happy, you know, just happy. Outside in the world, it was not a happy place. It was a very dull, grey, horrible, miserable, you know, no future, dull, you know, everything that Sex Pistols had highlighted, you know, it was just horrible out there. In a gay club, phew, great music, happy people.
Whenever I hear it now, even, it resonates completely. You know, that record came out of nowhere for most people, and it sounded like it came from outer space, and I think had a huge impact and influence.